Here's how some business groups reacted to the president's SONA. The Makati Business Club says it welcomes Marcos's push for the digitalization of government services. The business group also expressed support on the ease of paying taxes bill that has been passed by the House of Representatives. The Management Association of the Philippines, meanwhile, gave a passing score to the Marcos administration. Its Vice President, Attorney Alex Cabrera, notes Marcos missed a lot of pressing issues during his SONA.
I would say that there are many also important things which were not tackled, mm-hmm. and I couldn't miss out on the corruption being one of those issues. 67% of the CEOs believe that corruption could be a hindrance to the progress of this nation, and the president not tackling corruption as an issue among its priority areas. You know, I think that's very important for the president to miss. And very close to this is the Freedom of Information Bill, which was also not tackled as a priority bill. In fact, not one of those mentioned during the SONA. Mm-hmm. And I think it's also very important to mention initiatives on human rights, mm-hmm. for instance. And the fact that the government is no longer entertaining the ICC, mm-hmm. Investigations can also indicate, the track of the government on where human rights violations or dealing with human rights violations are headed.
Cabinet secretaries backing the accomplishments reported by the president in his SONA. Finance Secretary Benjamin Joaquin says the country's economic team is proud of what they have achieved so far. That these include sustained rapid GDP growth and easing inflation. He admits, though, the Philippines is still far from reaching its economic goals. But he notes government is working faster to push for more economic reforms that will benefit the nation. And meanwhile, the Interior and Local Government Department underscored Marcos's new approach in fighting illegal drugs.
Ang sinasabi ng presidente ganito, parang puno iyan eh. Kung puputuli mo sa nga, may ugat ka pa rin. Ang ugat ay yung mga batang re-recruit, mga batang nauuto. What is important is habang pinuputol mo yung sanga, yung mga drug pushers, inuugat mo rin ang problema. They go together. Hindi sasabihin ng presidente to kung hindi niya pinag-aralan to. He's been a seasoned lawmaker. No one can say that they have been successful here. But we will do it this way. Demand reduction and at the same time supply reduction.
A leadership marked with decisiveness, strength, and political will. That's how Vice President Sara Duterte described the presidency of Marcos, saying he inspires government officials to be aggressive in delivering campaign promises to the Filipino people. Now, Duterte, who is the education secretary, also thanked Marcos for pushing for education reforms in his SONA that benefit both students and teachers. She also lauded the president's development agenda for Mindanao, saying it brings optimism that efforts to stamp out terrorism will lead to meaningful progress in the region. Philippine senators, meanwhile, have mixed reactions to the president's second SONA. Senator Grace Bo said she's giving the president a high grade for his address, but she notes the implementation of the programs mentioned is a completely different matter.
Ang grado based ito sa content ng kanyang speech. Okay? Based sa content, syempre iba naman ang grado later on sa implementation. Pero ngayon, kung ibabase ko sa kanyang speech, malumanay, maayos, komprehensibo, sasabihin ko, 97%.
Mr. President, before we suspend the session...
Senator Joel Villanueva also says he's satisfied with the president's SONA. But the Senate's minority leader questions some statements made by Marcos.
Kung tignan natin yung figure na binigay ng presidente sa employment rate natin, practically we have full employment. And 96% plus, that is practically full employment. And I do not believe it because I could see unemployment all around.
The state of the nation is sound and improving. That's how Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. summed up his second State of the Nation address touting his administration's accomplishments in its first year. Jackie Pascual reports.
The economy, agriculture, health, education, and infrastructure. These are some of the key highlights of the second State of the Nation address of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. The chief executive admits the biggest problem of his administration is inflation. But he says efforts to curb rising commodity prices are on the right track. The consumer price index last month cooled to 5.4% after peaking at 8.7% in January.
In spite of all the difficulties, we are transforming the economy. We are stabilizing the prices of all critical commodities.
The chief executive, who is also the secretary of the Agriculture Department, touted his Kadiwa program, which he plans to expand to more areas. Marcos also issued a stern warning to smugglers and hoarders who have been blamed for the rising prices of agricultural products.
Taas ng presyo ay ang mga smuggler, mga hoarder, at mga nagmamanipula ng presyo ng produktong agrikultural. Hinahabol at ihaabla natin sila ang kanilang ginagawa. Napapahamak hindi lamang ang mga magsasaka, kundi tayo rin mga mamimiling. Bilang na ang mga araw ng mga smuggler at hoarder na yan.
The President also urged Congress to create the Department of Water Resource Management. Water conservation and building buffer stock are crucial due to the looming impact of El Nino.
Ang tubig ay kasing halaga rin ng pagkain. Kailangan natin tiyakin na may sapat at malinis na tubig para sa lahat at sa mga susunod na salinlahi.
Meanwhile, Marcos championed the 194 flagship infrastructure projects worth 8.3 trillion pesos under the Build Better More program, mostly our transport projects. And one way to help fund these projects, he says, is through the Maharlika Investment Fund. Marcos also made many other promises, like the electrification of all homes by the end of his term, recalibrating the K-10 curriculum to be at par with international standards, digitizing government services, and releasing the delayed COVID-19 health emergency allowance to health workers.
Upang masuklian naman natin ang naging sakripisyo ng ating mga health workers sa pribado at pampubliko ng mga ospital nung nakaraang pandemya, ipapamahagi na sa kanila ang kanilang COVID health emergency allowance at iba pang mga nabimbing benepisyo.
The President also spoke about boosting the recovery of war-torn Marawi, granting amnesty for rebel returnees, and the anti-drug campaign.
Campaign against illegal drugs continues, but it has taken on a new face. It is now geared towards community-based treatment, rehabilitation, education, and reintegration.
Marcos adds he will be accepting the resignations of rogue cops involved in the drug trade. Last January, Interior Secretary Benjamin Abalos called for the courtesy resignation of top policemen as part of an internal cleansing program.
Unscrupulous law enforcers and others involved in the highly nefarious drug trade have been exposed. I will be accepting their resignations. In their stead, we will install individuals with unquestionable integrity who will be effective and trustworthy in handling the task of eliminating this dreaded and corrosive social curse. We cannot tolerate corruption or incompetence in government.
In his last SONA, the President said the state of the nation is sound. This year, he says, it is improving. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
In the energy sector, Marcos commits to boosting the country's transition to renewable energy. But he also announced more gas explorations across the Philippines following the contract renewal of the Malampaya gas project.
Aside from Malampaya, we will also push for more gas exploration in other parts of the country. The national government has also partnered with the BARM in regard to energy exploration and development, and also its utilization within its territorial jurisdiction. We therefore expect to see renewed investor interest in its promising sites.
Marcos, meanwhile, says government's review of the country's sole grid operator continues. The NGCP faced scrutiny from lawmakers in the past months over China's 40% stake in the company.
However, 68 grid connections are much delayed, according to the ERC's count. We are conducting a performance review of our private concessionaire, the National Grid Corporation of the Philippines. We look to NGCP to complete all of its deliverables, starting with the vital Mindanao-Visayas and Cebu-Negros-Panay interconnections.